Hello, subscribers and first-time viewers. Welcome to the Kenny Hack. Today, I'm going to be kind of going a comparison of the magic marker method that I showed in the last video. Here's a sample. This was all, like in the last video, this was covered with magic marker. I ran this at 80% power and 3,500 millimeters per minute. And then afterwards, I used some magic markers. Not really magic markers. These are Copic markers. You can find these at Michael's and Hobby Lobby. They're pretty pricey markers. They can range up to about $3 a piece. I found a huge set of them online, like 100 some markers for like $100. I got them for about $1 a piece online used, but I've had these for years and they still hold up very well. They don't seem to dry out too easy. They're really, really good markers. Whether or not they actually work better than just a standard Sharpie, I don't know. I haven't ran enough tests. But you can get a lot more variety in colors with these artistic markers. But the problem with them, as you can see, if you go a little bit too heavy with the clear coat, they'll start to bleed out a little bit. So I'm still working on how to get that color in there and try to keep it from bleeding. I've been hitting it with a blow dryer really hard, trying to get the ink really dry. Put on really light mists of clear coat and then dry with the blow dryer on each mist and try to get two or three thin layers on, and hopefully that'll kind of seal in the ink, and then maybe give it a little more time to dry, and then you can maybe start hitting it with a little heavier layer to try to get a little more protective coat on it. It's still a work in progress, but it's something else, just a way to add color into your pieces without doing it all with paint. But back to the main deal of this video is, I think if you're doing a tile like this, that's just a straight black logo and the tile is remaining mostly white, I think this black marker method is a good method to have in your repertoire of skills. This one here only took about 12 minutes to burn, because you're not having to work the whole tile area to burn off all the excess paint that you put on. And with the markers, like the larger the areas start to do, you'll start to see the marker brush strokes in it after it burns even. And like you can see here, this was when I did, this was all done with magic marker. And if you're kind of sloppy putting the magic marker on, when it burns, you'll see some of the brush strokes. And this one here was done at 3,500 millimeters per minute, 85% power. It was traced and then used just the fill. This one here is just, I didn't clean off the tile. I just sprayed on two quick coats of black, matte black spray paint. Did a quick coat left to right, and then did another quick coat vertically. And just made sure I had everything evenly covered, but still trying to keep it thin enough to where I can kind of maximize my speed and power settings. Because like you said, you've seen my channels, I try not to run down in the slower speeds. I'm trying to see what the maximum speed I can run at. And typically 85% power is high as I run my laser. I don't buy into that it's okay to run diodes at 100%. Seems like everybody that's running at 100%, sooner or later their diodes start dying on them and they're losing power quicker. I don't think any laser should be run at 100% power for any kind of extended period. It's just my opinion anyway. Far as photo quality, this is the black paint on white tile. Once again, I didn't clean the tile off with acetone. I just directly spray painted it with the two quick coats. You can kind of see it transitions. The left side I did at 4,000 millimeters per minute. 85% power with the newsprint dither. The right side is at 4,500 millimeters per minute. Or 4,600. The left side was darker, but you can see in his coat, it was kind of getting pixelated. It didn't quite get enough to burn some of the heavier black areas off. Where the right side, I think it had better texture in his coat, but you're starting to lose some facial details. You weren't getting all them dark shadows in on his face. So I'm burning another one right now as I'm filming this, and hopefully by the time I'm done filming everything, I can show you. I set it to 4,300. I just split the difference. It's going to be about a 30-minute burn to do a 4-inch by 4-inch tile of a photo. And to me, that's if I could charge, do a 4x4-inch tile of somebody's photo and charge $10 a tile, if I'm getting roughly about $20 an hour for my diode, and I just base it all off my diode time just to kind of keep it simple. And if I'm getting $20 an hour for my diode laser, that's more than paying for itself. These tiles are only 8 cents a piece. The material cost isn't much. If I put a foam cork back on it to act as a coaster, that maybe adds another 30, 40 cents of the cost to it. It's still only 50 cents a tile. So a buck material cost. Overall, pretty cheap. And like I said, if I can do it in a photo in a half hour, if I sell a 3-pack or a 4-pack of somebody's photos for 30 or 40 bucks, depending on what package they want, I don't think I'm underselling my laser. I don't think I'm underselling the market or overpricing the market. If you look online, that, you know, $25 to $30 for a set of 4 coasters, depending on the material, is pretty reasonable. And here was like a little practice piece I was trying to invert images. Like this third strip here was at 4,000 millimeters, and that's with the Jarvis dither. You can see Jarvis. I know a lot of people really love Jarvis, and it might get finer details, but at the speeds I want to run to get to maximize my production time, I'd have had to really slow way more down to get Jarvis to work. And these were some newsprint dithers. Now, this wasn't a prepared image. I just shrunk it down in light burn. And when you just if you just grab an image in light burn and shrink it down, it starts getting really pixelated when it starts doing the dithers. You don't want to resize inside a light burn. Do all your sizing in a program like GIMP. Set it to what the final dimensions you want, what DPI you want, and then once it's set in like GIMP, when you import it into Lightburn, don't change any of the dimensions. Just leave it as it is. If you just move it 1 millimeter in size, it's going to distort all the DPI in there, and like especially with newsprint, all of a sudden it'll start getting really coarse looking like that. And if you can see here on this image, this one was prepped in GIMP, and you can see how less the pixelation is. Like here where it's overlapped, it started to get a little pixely, probably because I doubled up on the lines. And I mean, when you zoom way in, you can start to see a little pixelation, but at any greater distance, more than a foot or so, you can't see them little dots. Unless you got really good eyesight. So once again, I'm just a fan of the newsprint. I know a lot of people like Jarvis, and it does work really well. You'll probably just have to run at slower speeds than the 4,300. I don't think you'll be able to get that kind of speed out of the Jarvis dither. It just can't burn hot enough to do it. So once again, I kind of like newsprint. So that's kind of where I'm at. I said, in the future, I think for productivity, if a tile is mostly black and very little white, then you want to go with the black painted tile method. I mean, you have to spray these on, let them sit for at least 8 hours or so. I sprayed these on in the morning before I went to work, come back in the evening, and it had been about 10, 11 hours, and they are perfectly dry, ready to use, so no problems there. But that's what's nice about the marker method, is as soon as you slap on the marker and give it like a minute to dry, it's ready to go. So it's a little quicker, easier process. And these hold up to clear coating a little bit better, where if you're going to clear coat the painted tiles, you want to give them another day of drying before you put on the clear coat. If you just immediately put on some clear coat, I've seen a lot of people start having problems where it'll start scaling up, it'll start bubbling and peeling up the paint, and that's probably just because it wasn't quite done fuming off any of the vapors trapped inside the paint. So you want to give it another day's worth of drying time. And the first coat of clear coat, put it on really thin, maybe take a blow dryer to it, get it good, a little dry, and then put on another thin coat, dry it, and then start building it up. If you just slap on a really heavy coat, you can start peeling up the paint, is just what I've seen in the forums. These are my first couple tries at this painted tile method. This is finally getting around to it. Kind of been stuck on wood and canvas and slate and just hadn't got to the tiles yet. But they are really cheap materials. I mean, 8 cents a piece. I mean, yes, if I didn't like how it turned out, I could take some acetone to this, wipe all the paint off, but at 8 cents a tile, it's probably not worth wasting the acetone even on it. I got a box of 100 of them for $8, so I can definitely have a few scrap ones to throw out. But just kind of a quick video. I'll show you the picture of this one when I get it done. It's only going to take about another 10 minutes or so, and it should be done. I'll show you the outcome of that, and we'll wrap things up and go from there. So here's the final reburn. This was at 4,300 millimeters per minute, 85% power. Overall, I'm pretty pleased with that outcome for not even being a HD image. I'm pretty sure if I had a high definition image, the quality had been even better than this. But for my first try at it, only took me about 20 minutes, 30 minutes worth of burning a couple test patterns to figure out what I wanted and the power I wanted. I had a good idea on where to burn black off, like just with all the stuff I've done on glass work. That stuff, I usually put it on a little heavier than I did with this, but I'm usually right around 4,000 power just to burn it clear off if I'm clearing all the paint off. So I had a pretty good idea on kind of where to start. So that made it a little bit easier. So side by side, I kind of like the detail I got in his face with that one, but I don't like how his coat kind of turned out. This one here, his face is a little bit lighter, but I think the overall texture on the coat turned out better. So I'm pretty happy with that 4,300 speed. Half hour production time for a 4-inch by 4-inch tile. It's pretty good. I didn't use any plugins with this. I didn't use no big GIMP or ImageR. This was taken, rescaled in GIMP, come right to Lightburn. Come in here to my, shape properties. 1.35 gamma, negative 15 contrast, 15 brightness, 15 on the enhancements. And that's a pretty close to a typical setting I use on wood with a lot of my pictures. That's kind of a good starting point for me. Sometimes I might adjust something a little more if I'm trying to adjust on how much mid-tones I'm getting into it. But for me, if I'm burning test patterns, not using any plugins, that's a pretty good spot for me to start. And kind of like with the wood, basically how it shows up on the screen was pretty close to how I got it on the tile. There's a little bit detail lost on his head. I can see a couple of the lines didn't quite get burnt in as heavy, but very minute difference. And that's always handy when you can kind of adjust the image, and what you almost see on the screen is what you're getting for your output. There's some materials I've tried where it has to look quite a bit different on the screen to get a good output on your surface, but so far the tile is lining up pretty close. So I hope you enjoyed this video. Hope it helped you out. Please like, subscribe, comment below. Ask any questions you need. I always try to answer everybody if I can. Thanks for watching, and we'll see you on the next video.